This video is sponsored by Blinkist. I remember when I was a kid that sometimes I'd notice that an older atlas or map I owned would have a different name for a place than a more modern atlas or map. I would often be curious as to why the names were different, and when did they change? The most common name change, though, that I noticed was with cities. So I figured for this video, I'll talk about some famous cities that have had name changes over the years and why they happened. First, we have the obvious one that everyone is probably already thinking of. Byzantium to Constantinople to Istanbul. Byzantium became Constantinople after it became an imperial capital for the Roman Empire, named after Emperor Constantine the Great. Sometimes it was the sole capital of the whole thing, sometimes it was the only capital of the East. Regardless, it became an important city, so they named it after an important guy. So after that name change, why did it change again to Istanbul? You would think that it was because of the Ottoman capture of Constantinople in 1453, but Constantinople remained the name of the city officially. Even in Turkish, it was officially called Konstantiniye, but the city had nicknames that people used. For the Greeks, it was common when referring to it to use the phrase Istimbolin, which meant to the city. After all, for centuries, it was the largest city in the region by far. It was the city. You also have the Turkish phrase Istanbul, which means plentiful Islam. As time went on, you had more people of the city referring to it as Istanbul. Whether it came more from the Greek phrase, or the Turkish phrase, or both, it was the common name used by the city citizens. In 1923, the Ottoman Empire ended and became the Turkish Republic. In 1930, they officially renamed the city to Istanbul since, well, that's what the people called it. Since the goal of Turkey was to make the former Ottoman Empire seem more modern, giving it a more modern name seemed to fit. For another example, we have a few cities in India that had some name changes in the modern age. The cities of Madras, Bombay, and Calcutta changed their names to Chennai, Mumbai, and Kolkata, respectively. For these cities, and several others, the reason for the name change was due to a shift in language policies. India as a country is not only super diverse in ethnicity, but in language as well. 8 languages share the official status, and most are regional aside from Hindi and English. But despite English being the least Indian language culturally, it was a lingua franca being used by Indians due to its former history as a colony. So whenever people outside of India decided to name the cities and maps and stuff like that, it was more common to use the anglicized name rather than an individual language. Calcutta is basically saying the Bengali name Kolkata, but with a more commonly used British English accent. But by the late 20th century and early 21st century, many cities decided to officially change their names to ones used by the local dominant language instead, and therefore more maps and labels followed suit. Therefore, Calcutta went back to Kolkata, since Bengali is the most common language in the area. The United States is no exception to name changes either, like how Eugene, Oregon used to briefly be called Skinner's Mudhole. But a more modern example was the former city of Barrow, Alaska. This settlement was notable for being the northernmost settlement in the United States, but in 2016 they changed their name officially to Utqiagvik, which is a local Inuit name, and almost 2/3 of the city is Inuit, so it makes sense. So you might be noticing that local culture and languages have a lot to do with these name changes. It goes to show that other subjects can cross over into history, so it's nice to know more about them. But sometimes you just don't have the time to fully read dozens of books on dozens of subjects, especially at a quick pace. That's why I recommend the app from this video's sponsor, Blinkist. Blinkist takes books and condenses them to 15 to 20 minute summaries so you can just read the essentials. That way you can gather information a lot quicker, especially if you have a longer reading list. You can even listen to it in audiobook form as well. With over 14 million users, Blinkist has proven to be a popular app used by many people. I myself saw a neat book titled A History of the World in 6 Glasses, and considering my reading list is already 7 books long, this was the perfect way to find time to slip in a sudden eye-catching title of a book. Click the link below in the description to get 7 days of Blinkist Premium for free, and if you extend to full membership, you get 25% off each month for the first year. Thanks again to Blinkist for sponsoring this video. Sometimes the city name change isn't due to language, but due to changing times. In several areas that used to be European colonies, some cities with European names were changed to more native-sounding names after the colony ended. One notable example is in Zimbabwe, where the capital used to be called Salisbury when it was the British colony of Rhodesia, as well as during the time in which it was an apartheid state. Salisbury was named after the prime minister at the time of initial colonization, who happened to be the third Marquis of Salisbury, hence the name. Understandably, after colonization, they didn't like that, so in 1982 it was renamed to Harare. For the final city, boy do we have a lot of name changes. We know the Chinese capital today as Beijing, but this city has more name changes than perhaps any other city. Before I go through them all, I need to set some background here. In reality, Chinese has always been more of a language group than a language itself. The current official language of China is Mandarin. Because of that, you'll most likely learn Mandarin if you choose to learn Chinese. However, there are other varieties with millions of speakers, like Cantonese, Wu, and so on. Some are similar, just like mere dialects. Some are different as, like, say, Spanish versus Portuguese. And then some are even more different sounding, like comparing Spanish to French, or French to Romanian. But just like how those languages are a part of the Romance language group, because they all come from Latin, the same applies to the Chinese languages because of that common culture and ancestry. But they are also unified on writing, at least for the most part. Then you also have a factor in China's history in which culturally many cities had names with meaning. As a result, not only have cities changed names over different meanings, but also could be referred to differently in one part of China compared to another. Imagine it like how Spanish speakers would say Nueva York instead of New York because while York is a proper name, New is a word that has different translations. Makes sense? Good. So with that in mind, Beijing has had a lot of different names. It started out as the city of Ji when it was founded around 1045 BC. Sometimes it would be called Jicheng, which means walled city of Ji. When briefly conquered by the Yan, it became Yanjing, which means capital of Yan. But despite that, Ji was still used as a name. Future dynasties would have a similar idea where Ji was the official name of the city and especially used by the populace, but it would be referred to as blank capital of whatever mini dynasty controlled the city or province of a bigger dynasty controlled the city. Yuzhou, Zhuojun, and Fanyan would go back and forth as the administrative name along with Yanjing, despite Ji still being the city's name. Confusing, I know. But eventually in the 10th century, under the Liao dynasty, the name settled to Nanjing, which meant southern capital. This is not to be confused with the other Nanjing that existed in southern China into a more modern time period. Nanjing was used here because for the Liao dynasty, Ji was pretty far south. But then the Jin dynasty brought back Yanjing, the Song dynasty took the capital for a brief moment and called it Yanshan, which meant Yan Mountain City, and then back to Yanjing when the Mongols came along, and just like with everywhere else they conquered, things calmed down. Just kidding. The Mongols flat out burned the city down and rebuilt it from scratch, and thus arose two new names. Khanbalik was the Mongol name that meant City of the Khan, which admittedly sounds pretty cool, but for the Chinese it was called Dadu, which meant Grand Capital. Then the Ming dynasty overthrew the Mongols and de-Mongoled everything. Dadu was thusly renamed Beiping, which meant Northern Peace. That sounds nice. At times, the Yongle Emperor of the Ming dynasty gave the city additional nicknames such as Shunqian and Jinshi, which meant obedience to heaven and just another word for capital, respectively. Beiping as a name would return though, and at times when it would be the capital for the Ming and Qing dynasties or for a province, it would of course be referred to as Beijing. But it's not over yet. During the Republic of China, after the Qing dynasty was overthrown, there were problems with warlord governments in the north. So as a result, Nanjing, as in this Nanjing, became the capital again. So when the nationalist government retook the city from warlords, it reverted back to Beiping. But then the Japanese invaded China and it got more complicated. So in the late 1800s and early 1900s, the West had been trying to find ways to transliterate Chinese characters and words into Western letters. But the truth of the matter is that Chinese has some phonetic sounds that English, French, Spanish, and other Western languages simply do not have. So as a result, the spellings were approximates, Technically speaking, Beijing is pronounced like this, an IPA, which, forgive me if this isn't perfect, is closer to sounding like Beijing. Similarly, Beiping would be closer to Pieping, but with these differences, some systems translated it to as Beiping, others as Peiping. As a result, when trying to modernize with the West, Peiping was a common name used by the West. When Japan invaded China and took Beiping, they made a puppet government called the Provisional Government of the Republic of China. So they made Beiping a capital for that puppet, which meant, once again, it was Beijing. But the West called it Peking. So any official businesses done by China and Japan involving the area that didn't use Chinese characters used Peiping and Peking. Of course, eventually Japan lost and the nationalists preferred it to be called Beiping/Peiping, despite Peking becoming such a popular name used in the West that to this day there are several universities, restaurants, and cultural items both in and out of China that kept the name Peking. But after the Chinese Communist Party won the Civil War, they made Beiping Beijing once again. Eventually, the Wade-Giles system, which was the system used to transliterate Chinese into Roman characters, declined in popularity as an arguably more accurate system called Pinyin became the official romanization system. So Peking was quickly abandoned, and Beijing has been the name ever since. Holy crap, that was so many name changes. To think though, there are many other cities that have name changes, even if not as dramatic and plentiful as Beijing. But that'll conclude this video. I'm Emperor Tiger Star, and I'll see you guys next time.